Hey there. So in this video, I'm going to talk about gate.io and why I think they may be the best alternative to Binance in Canada at the time of recording this video. Now, the reason why I think that they're okay to use across Canada is because as we can see from this post over here, which was updated 5 days ago, it says that Canadian users are supported on gate.io now, but it just says that the services are limited. It says that you may not be able to access services such as lending, margin trading, perpetual contract trading, and the trade of some coins. So this makes me believe that they're following what regulators have imposed and are thus limiting those services. I think that this is a good sign as they're proactive in making sure that we can only access what regulators deem appropriate. So now that we know that gate.io should be okay across Canada, fingers crossed, I'll talk about what makes them an exchange worth using. So the very first reason is the coins that they offer. If we go over here to market and click on market price, it'll bring us to this page of all the coins that they have on their exchange. Now, if I kind of just scroll down, it's a pretty comprehensive list, so I don't want to waste your time to go through everything that they have on their list. You can see it's quite lengthy, and they'll probably have the coins that you're looking to trade. Not all coins are available to trade, though, as they did say, and it'll inform you of which coins you can not trade, as it'll bring a pop-up and then it'll tell you to confirm and to leave. Now, I haven't had the chance to see all the coins that can be traded, but of the coins that I was interested in, I didn't have any issues. As for liquidity, they're actually rated top 10 globally among crypto exchanges, so you shouldn't see too much of an issue with liquidity. If you're a whale, however, you may be better off with Coinbase Pro, though for most users, I would say that you should be fine with gate.io's liquidity. The second reason to use them is their reasonable trade fees. So their fees are 0.2% for makers and 0.2% for takers, just as you can see over here. But you can prepay for your fees with their points program. So instead of the 0.2%, it'll be 0.06% for makers and takers. However, the minimum purchase of the points is 120 USDT. This may be worth it if you plan on using gate.io for the long run. The other option is to pay with GT, which reduces the trade fees to 0.15% for both makers and takers. But unfortunately, GT is one of those coins that's unavailable for Canadian residents to trade, so this option here really isn't available to us. Also, if you're interested, I've got a sign-up link that can help you save 30% on your trade fees, which means more crypto for you and less in fees. The third reason why I like them is because you can fund them with either BUSD or XLM. If you've seen my video on funding Binance for the cheapest way in Canada, the same video applies to this over here with gate.io. So nothing is different with regards to funding. Now, the last reason why I like them is because of their trade features. They have the standard limit, market, and stop. However, they have these other advanced trade features that I still don't really understand yet, but I'll look more into them later on. They have trade features such as iceberg, IOC, grid trading, and time conditions, which are all new to me that I've never really seen before, but it sure does look interesting. So there you have it. That's why I think gate.io is the best alternative to Binance in Canada. They've been around since 2017 and are still around today, which I think says a lot. I really do hope that they stay compliant with regulators, and that way we can use them without worrying about needing to close our accounts. As I do think they're an exchange worth using, I'll be making tutorial videos on them in the future. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video or found it educational. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you're interested in receiving notifications on my future videos, then hit that subscribe button. If you think that there's someone who'll get some value out of this video, please share with them. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.